I showed you how to use an LT1 tester when we did the video on making Loconet cables, and I said I would show you how to use this same tester to test your decoders before you install them on your locomotive. Now, I have one here that has 8-pin connector on it, and it has an extra wire on it since it's a 3-function decoder. I'm going to show you how to test this decoder with the LT1 tester for the motor and the lighting functions on it. So let's get started with that right now. I'm Tom Kvitchak, and this is Tom's Trains and Things. This channel was created to help other modelers who are in need of guidance in pursuing their dream of building their model railroad. Now, if you ever buy a decoder and you want to make sure that it is good before you put it in your locomotive, or you just want to play around with the wires on it to make sure your lights are working properly and you want to know what wires go to what function, this decoder right here is a DN136PS from Digitrax. It's an N-scale decoder. It has 3 functions on it: headlights forward and reverse, and this little green wire right here is another function that you could use for something else on there. It comes with an 8-pin connector. A lot of locomotives have the receptacle in there already with a little circuit board. It makes it really easy to install the decoder on your locomotive that way. Now, this one has an extra function on it that you could hook up to whatever you want, and we'll talk about that in a little bit. I'm going to show you this. I'm going to show you how to use the LT1, and I'll show you how to hook these wires up here, and we're all going to put it on this little breadboard right here, so to make things a little bit easier. So let's get started with it right now. To test a decoder with the LT1 that you get from Digitrax, what Digitrax says is take the yellow and red wire, strip it back, and the green and the black wire and strip it back, and twist the green and black together, and then the red and yellow together. When they first strip this back, they don't give you very much room. What I did was I took the X-Acto knife, went down about this far, and stripped back a little bit more. So you see about right there, just to give you a little bit more wire to work with. And then I'll strip that out and we'll start working with that, about that amount of wire right there. And also what I'm going to do is I'm going to solder the ends of these, but we'll just use one of these small breadboards here and we'll punch our wires into there. From the command station, our track power, we'll put it on one of these little terminals here so we could screw it on there and then push this down onto the breadboard so we have our track power on the breadboard so we could test our decoder. I prepared the wires, have the flux on it right now, and I'm going to tin them so they'll go into the breadboard very easily. Those look pretty good. So what I'll do, wipe these things off. All right, now we got them looking pretty good right now. And I just want to test them out on the breadboard to make sure that they'll go in now. Okay, that one works good. I made this breadboard so I can wire everything in. These 2 leads right here are going to go right here to the command station. Now here's the resistor, 100 ohm, 2 watt resistor. I have the 2 leads right here and right here. So it's coming from here and moving over here. So that will be the red and the black. I marked this one black over here on the end so we could distinguish that. Now, these wires here, These are female, so I could put a pin, so I could plug the pins into there. Now, since I don't have a receptacle to put that 8-pin plug into, I was looking for one of my old locomotives so I could tear one out of there to make it a little bit easier, but I couldn't find it. So I had to deal with this little breadboard right here. So two of the pins from the connector are going to go right here. That's going to be the red and the black wire here. Now I have the LT1, all four wires hooked up to the LT1. The two on the outside are the black and green and the red and yellow. So that's what I have these connectors hooked up to right now, so we could test the motor on the decoder right now. Now, whenever we want to check the functions, like the light functions on there, test other decoder functions by connecting the LT1 to the blue decoder common and one of the function leads. So the blue decoder common, that's your light common on the decoder. And then you have white on the decoder is the forward light, yellow is the reverse light, and then we have the green, which is the one that's not on the connector. That is the other function, function one. Now on this one, we don't have a function two and function three, so we just have one extra function on this one. It's only a three function one. Now I have everything hooked up on here. I have my breadboard all connected to the decoder. I have the motor leads in there, and I have the rail leads in there. And I have the LT1 right here. Let me flip it over this way. And what we're looking for is the two LEDs in the center of the LT1. We want them to light up. Now, let me put power on. Put this in the run mode right here. Okay, and then put power on. And it says the power is already on. Okay, so you see the LED lighting up. And it gets a little bit brighter as I increase the speed. Okay, I'll change the direction. And the other LED lights up. Now that's what we're looking for. Let me shut the power off. Okay. Now what I had to do was, this is the rail A and rail B coming in. So I had to make sure that that was on the correct ones, the black and the red wire. So the black is this lead back here, and the red one is just the opposite corner. And then for the other, the gray and the orange lead going to the motor is the other two wires, which is this and just the opposite corner. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to check the functions on here. So let me cut the power off on this, and I'll redo these two leads over here that go to the LT1. I'll have to put one on the blue and the other one on one of the functions. Now this is a three function decoder, so, and what I'm going to have to do, I'll probably have to strip this one right here and see if I can get this inside there to get it going. I now connected the two leads to the blue and the white, and that's these two right here. And that, the blue is the common and the white is the forward headlight. So we'll put this back on. Put power back on. Make sure this isn't going forward. And there's the headlight right there. And then we'll turn the light off and back on. And off and on. Okay, now we'll put it on the rear light, which is the blue and the yellow. So I'll just take it off the white. and the yellow is directly behind the blue. So we'll go back here and stick it right here. Turn power back on. Watch this right here. Reverse it and turn the light off. Turn the light on. Okay, now what we're going to have to do is I'm going to strip the green wire. All right, I got it in there, but it's loose. So we'll put this up. Now, hopefully that'll continue with the contact. Now this is F1, and that works. So we know that the forward headlight works, the reverse headlight works, and the one function. Now we could change what function button the green wire goes to in the CVs, but we're not going to do that here. We're just going to use it as function one. Okay, this is not a sound decoder, so we're not going to get the bell in there, but we could use that for another light. Say, for instance, you want to light up the cab in the locomotive. You could put a light in there and hit the F1 key, and the light will come on in the cab or wherever else you want to put it. Now, what I made here on the breadboard is just a temporary project. And if you would like to make it permanent, you could mount this because they have an adhesive backing on there. You could mount this on anything and you can keep all these items on here. In fact, you could even use one of these little terminal blocks over here for the LT1 cable. I just put the wires directly into the breadboard. Now, as far as these right here, I didn't have any male to female ones, so I had to use the female one along with a male header so I could plug it into the breadboard. And you could see the male header right on the end of that jumper right there. But if you have a socket for your plug on your decoder, you can run wires permanently to that socket and put them in the breadboard here to make life a little bit easier. If you would like to do this permanently, if you have a lot of decoders, you could even do this on a circuit board. They have circuit boards with the same whole configurations on there that you can get at any electronic store or even at Amazon. So check it out. Just like any other decoder or locomotive, whenever using it for the first time, you're going to have to set up your throttle to 03 so your command station will recognize it. I use these little jumper wires right here. They have a female end on them. They are a lot bigger than the connector on the circuit board that you get with your decoders. These were made for the male headers that you would put on a breadboard, and this is what a male header looks like. I had to take my pliers and just squeeze it a little bit on the end that I wanted to hook up to my decoder. Just squeeze it just a little bit so it would grab onto the pins. Otherwise, it would just fall right off the pins, just like that there. All the supplies and tools that I used in this video and other videos can be seen on my new Amazon page. It's www.amazon.com/shop/tomstrainsandthings. So you could find a lot of good stuff over there. I have some books on there for track planning. I have some Digitrax products on there. There's some new train sets for you beginners. There's tools and supplies on there if you want to do any kind of electronic projects like this one here or any other project that I do on my videos. So go check that out. Amazon.com/shop/tomstrainsandthings. And don't forget to leave a comment down below. I like to read your comments, and you can get a lot of good information because I make videos from those comments where you could learn from other modelers. So leave a comment down below, and any links that I have, I'll put them in the description also. So thank you. If you like this video or any other of my videos and learn something from it, go ahead and check out my Patreon page where you can contribute to my efforts to bring you better quality videos so you could learn model railroading and everything about it. So check out my Patreon page, patreon.com/TomKovichak. Thank you. All it takes is $1, just $1 pledge per month, per video, and you could even limit that to just one video so you only have to pay $1. If you'd like to contribute more, you could do $1 two times, three times, five times, or even as much as you want, or even contribute $5. You could limit the amount that you give per month on Patreon. So I want to thank you very much for the ones that already are contributing on Patreon. And if you haven't done so already, go head on over there and you could help out with supplies and parts to do these videos so I could give better content for you so you could learn more about model railroading and how you could use electronics in model railroading. So thank you very much, and we'll see you.